Do you have this experience where you ask a question on Stack Overflow and you don't get any response? Or maybe you are working in a company and you have developed this impression that this person is annoying, he's asking so many questions, and none of your colleagues or manager want to help you. It could be that you do not know how to ask the question in a right way. Based on my own industry experience, I'm gonna share some tips on how you can ask a technical question in a right way, either in person or on a technical forum such as Stack Overflow. And if you use these strategies, it will increase the probability of you getting an answer. So the first one is, when you're asking a question less on Stack Overflow, say you are facing a technical error when running your Python code. Instead of just saying that I'm running this sklearn code and it is having an error, can someone help me please? Instead of asking that, you can say that I'm facing this error in my sklearn code and I have checked sklearn documentation and it is complaining about alpha parameter and I'm thinking I'm supplying the right value. I have done this, I have tried to troubleshoot in XYZ manner as well, but not finding an answer. Can someone give me troubleshooting direction? When we ask the first question, where you are directly asking for ready-made answer, you are showing your poor, helpless personality. And in that case, no one would help you. When you ask the question in a second alternate way, you are showing that you are doing your due diligence. You are trying to help yourself first and you are doing all the hard work and all the fight. And you're still not finding the answer, so you're looking for a guidance. You're not looking for a ready-made answer. So whenever you ask question on Stack Overflow or in person, show that you're not a poor, helpless person. You have your self-esteem and you have done all your due diligence and all you're looking for is some direction, some pointer. When people find this kind of personality in you, people will automatically help you, whether it's Stack Overflow or whether it is on job. Also, if someone responds to a question and if you have counter question, first be thankful, because the other person is finding his or her time to help you, so you need to be helpful. Say thanks for spending your valuable time in answering my question. I think what you're saying makes sense, but I have this counter question. Do you think that this line of code that I have, maybe that might be giving the trouble? And explain your reasoning on why you are thinking that way. So again, that will result in a very productive dialogue and you will find the answer of your question at the end of the day. The second tip, especially on Stack Overflow or on email, is provide a meaningful title to your question. The title should not be sklearn error, someone please help. The title should be sklearn fit function is not accepting 1D array as an input. Instead of just saying that sklearn fit function is giving an error, you know. So when you give meaningful title, that title should have all the information related to the problem in a concise, small, concise and compact way, so that when other people are trying to help, they are very busy and they want to spend minimum amount of time on your question. So you need to give all the details. Also, in the question body, try to give a context of the problem. Don't just say, okay, I'm finding this error, someone help. It's like you're giving up. You have to give a context that I'm trying to do XYZ thing and this is the code that I'm running and at this line I'm finding an error. I'm thinking this could be the scenarios, or here is what I have done to troubleshoot the problem and I did not have any success. Maybe you tried XYZ thing already, and if you don't mention that in a question, the other person might suggest you the same thing. You're like, okay, try this X thing, but then you have tried it. So if you mention that in the question, it will help the person on the other end who is trying to answer your question. Also on Stack Overflow, try to include meaningful tags. The tags are very important in finding the questions related to specific topic. I'm going to include an article of Stack Overflow where they have mentioned how you can ask the questions in a right way. They have mentioned different bad and good situations. So please make sure you read this article. Now, when you are working in a company and when you are asking a question in person, there is some protocol that we need to follow. Let's say I'm facing an error. If I go to my colleague directly, who might be busy, instead of that, you know, you can maybe message that person or maybe go directly to that person and say, hey, I have this question. I'll probably take 10 minutes. Do you have time now? If the person is busy doing something, if you start asking a question, the person is not in a state to receive that information because maybe he's going through a different like mindset altogether. So whoever you're trying to ask the question, try to think from that person's perspective. What mindset that person is going through? Is he or she in a position to help you out? So there are some protocols that you need to follow. I hope all these tips are very helpful to you. If you know of any other tips on how you can ask question, especially technical question, in a right way, please post in a video comment below and try this out. The most important of all the tips is you want to maintain your self-dignity. You don't want to look like you are a poor, helpless person because you are not. Maybe you have less knowledge. Maybe you just joined the team as a fresher, and that's fine. Not having knowledge is not a problem, but you still have your self-dignity. Maintain that all the time and show it to the other person that you have done your due diligence and you are looking for only guidance and direction. You're not looking for a ready-made answer. Even in in-person conversation, once you find enough pointers, I have seen some strong people who will say, all right, wait, stop here. I think I have the pointers. I will be able to find the answer on my own. So that shows the attitude that you have willingness to help yourself. And when you have that, other people are more likely to help you. I receive many questions on LinkedIn, even in YouTube comments. I will show you one very common problem that question that I'm receiving in my linear regression tutorial. When I did that tutorial, linear regression fit method used to accept 1D array. After that, they changed the API. So now you have to supply 2-dimensional array. Now, many people who are trying that old code, facing this error, they come to my YouTube directly post the error. Say, sorry, I'm facing this error. And I don't want to help those people, to be honest. Because if you just do copy of that error and Google it, in 1 second you will find the answer. So before asking someone for a help, please do at least Google, right? And if you don't do that, and if you're posting, say I'll show you a screenshot. So many people have asked this question, and I even put a pinned comment. People are not even reading pinned comment. They are just running my code blindly without thinking. And when they find the error, they copy paste the error, put it in a video comment. Very bad strategy. You will not get any help in the future. So help yourself first before you ask for help to any other person. Thank you.